Well, hello and welcome to this Earth Day practice. I'm saying practice because I just before I clicked record had an idea. I'll talk about more about that in a minute. So if this is your first time on my channel here, welcome and please subscribe and follow if you enjoy this meditation. And today, 22nd of April, as of the time of recording this, is also known as Earth Day. Now, Earth Day was actually founded in 1970, so over 50 years ago, which is amazing, really, isn't it? That we're still destroying this planet, you know. But let's not be completely focused on the negative. I mean, Earth Day is a positive thing. It was founded in response to a massive oil spill in the United States and to raise awareness of the importance of protecting our planet and reducing environmental destruction. Now, I was reflecting a bit before starting this video that we can't avoid, you know, some kind of a destruction. You know, even if we were vegetarians or vegans, we still pull up plants to eat them and things like that. So it's for me, it's about finding that balance about what we can do. And it can be easy to get overwhelmed because I believe the theme for this year's Earth Day is reducing plastics. Now, gosh, I was reading up to get some facts about Earth Day, and I saw that they want to reduce it by 60% by 2040. Which is not a lot, really, is it, when you think about how much plastic is produced? But, you know, as I say, it's easy to get overwhelmed, but I think, you know, we have to focus on what we can do as individuals and do our best. Meditating helps us become more aware of everything. And so today, the focus is going to be on green Tara. Now, this is green Tara. She's quite heavy. I bought her in India, a symbol from Buddhism and Tibetan Buddhism. And you can see, if you can see, I'll move it closer to the camera, that in her one of her feet, it's like stepping down into the earth, and her hand is open as well. And she's also known as the earth goddess and protecting Mother Earth. So you could say that today is her day. It's back. So going on to today's practice then. So what I recommend is turning off all distractions. If you want, you can light a candle. If you've got a aroma, I've also got some incense burning over there. And I've got other candles lit around my room. I've put my little lights on my plants, you know. Anything that sort of inspires you to feel that connection with the earth. And you can start by just feeling the ground beneath you. Even if we're inside, you know, my feet are on the carpet, but obviously there's that support underneath from the earth, the gravity that sort of pulls us down. We're always supported. And I think that's a good way of reminding us that we are supported. I also love crystals, and I can't remember what this one is. I've got it written down somewhere. But crystals are very grounding, just holding them. And the colours generally tend to represent, they could be linked to the chakras, for example. And brown ones, I feel, because brown is the colour of the earth. And this is quite a big one. And I hold it in my hand and it's just like, feels really, really grounding when I hold it. And I do know that that was what the property of that that crystal is, and I'm going to look up what it's called and I'll put it in the description below. And yeah, or just any stones. I've got loads of stones around my flat because I picked them up off the beach. But yeah, but anything that reminds you of that connection to the earth, the browns, the greens, the plants, stones, or whatever, to remind us as well that we're not separate from the earth. We're part of nature. We're all connected and we're part of it. When we breathe out carbon dioxide, the plants absorb it and convert it back into oxygen, which then we can breathe. And no one organism can exist in isolation. So, coming on to the practice. So now you should hopefully feeling a bit more grounded and feeling the breath. If you want, you can have a soft focus on something in front of you, a candle, a statue, a plant, a flower, or if you wish, close your eyes. Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Swaha. 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 Feeling the breath in the body. And the connection with the earth. And you can imagine, as you breathe in, breathing up through the soles of the feet, up through the legs, the base chakra, and up to the torso and into the heart. And then as you breathe out, just breathing out through the heart and sending love and healing energy out into the world. And Now feel free to do a few more of those breaths, breathing up through the soles of the feet, right from the centre of the earth. Just imagine drawing on that up into your heart, and then spreading that love, that energy out into the world. You can just do that in your own time. And don't worry about any thoughts or sounds or anything going on around you. Just let that carry on while you remain focused on the breath and the earth. And if it helps, you can imagine that you're surrounded by nature, wherever you are right now. You can imagine a forest, a mountain, a beach and the sea. Whatever helps you to feel connected to the earth, to all the other living organisms that inhabit this planet alongside us. Just allow your imagination to connect in whatever way feels right and genuine for you. You might be feeling connected to plants or animals. Just the earth itself. Minerals and rocks that make up the structure of the earth. And all together is a living, breathing organism. thing of beauty, awe and wonder. And we're part of that too. And now becoming aware of the sounds of nature in your immediate environment, whether that's birds singing, other animals, the wind, rain, and the elements. And if you find that your mind wanders off, come back to feeling the breath. And you can do some more earth breathing to help ground and calm the mind. And now, just having a sense of the whole of the body, the space around your body, and the air as you breathe in and out. We're not always aware of the air unless it's windy. That oxygen and atmosphere that surrounds the earth and keeps us alive. Thank you for joining me here today, and please support my work by sharing this meditation with your friends and family. And if you feel moved to support me further so I can reach more people, please make a donation, buy me a cup of tea, and the link is in the description below. And I will see you again very soon. And very soon, actually, because it's full moon this week as well. In the meantime, take care, go well, and lots of love.